Good morning, children. This is the third part of the isolation process. Before going to that, two definitions you should know. First is pyrometallurgy, the process of extraction of a metal by heating the metal oxide with a suitable reducing agent is known as pyrometallurgy. Here, heat is the principal medium of extracting metal from ores. Hydrometallurgy. The process of extraction of a metal by dissolving the ore in a suitable reagent followed by precipitation or displacement of the metal by a more electropositive metal is known as hydrometallurgy. Now we will explain thermodynamic principle of metallurgy. Metallurgical process involve various principles of chemistry in which thermodynamic principles are very important. In order to understand this metallurgy transformation, knowledge of basic concepts of thermodynamics or related terms like Gibbs energy is required. According to the concept of thermodynamics, change in Gibbs free energy for any process at any specified temperature is del G is equals to del H minus T del S, where del H is enthalpy change, del S is entropy change, and del G is free energy change. For any reaction, this change could be explained through the equation del G naught is equals to minus RT log E K, where K is the equilibrium constant of the reaction at temperature T. A negative del G implies that K is positive, which means reaction is proceeding in forward direction. In metallurgical process, when the value of del G is negative, only then reaction will proceed. For this, del H is always positive, del S is also positive, and only at high temperature T del S is greater than del H. If the value of del G is positive for any reaction, then to make such reaction spontaneous, it is coupled with another reaction of large negative del G value, so that the sum of two del G becomes negative. This is known as coupling reaction. The reduction is of metal oxide to metal by a reducing agent may be the subtraction of two half equation. For example, the decomposition of Fe2O3, that is in the solid, gives 4Fe plus 3O2 and equals to, that is minus 1, sorry, plus del G is equals to plus 1487 kilojoule per mole. 2CO plus O2 gives 2CO2 and del G naught is equals to minus 514.4 kilojoule per mole. And if we combine both those two equation, then we will get 2Fe2O3 plus 6CO gives 4Fe plus 6CO2 and del G naught is equals to minus 56.2 kilojoule per mole. As the value of del G naught is negative, the reaction is feasible and spontaneous. To predict the feasibility of thermal reduction of an ore, we draw a plot between Gibbs free energy and the temperature. So we will explain the Ellingham diagram. The graphical representation of Gibbs energy change versus absolute temperature for formation of oxide is known as Ellingham diagram. It is shown in this figure. Okay, so in this diagram we will only explain the importance of Ellingham diagram. It gives a basis for the selection of reducing agent for the reduction of particular metal oxide. It predicts the feasibility of thermal reduction of the ore. The criteria of feasibility is that at given temperature, Gibbs energy of the reaction must be negative. Third, it shows the reduction of the oxide of the elements in upper line invisible by the elements present in the lower line. Reduction is easier if the difference is large. It explains the first reaction rate when the ore melts down, and the limitation is for Hellingham diagram, the interpretation of free energy will be true only when reactants and products are in equilibrium. That is, MXO plus A reduction give XM plus AO oxidation. Second, it explains thermodynamics feasibility of reduction process but does not give any idea about kinetics of reduction process. So these are the two demerits of the Hellingham diagram. So end of this